Module 1, Lesson 1. Creating effective presentations using PowerPoint. During this presentation, we will learn beautiful tips so as to create powerful PowerPoint presentations. So, why to use the PowerPoint? First of all, to hold the interest for our audience, to focus attention, to guide discussions, overviews, to tell a story, and to support the message being delivered. Now, let's see what is a good or a bad presentation. The best PowerPoint presentations should not be remembered. Instead, they should fall into the background to support you and the message you are trying to get across. What does stand out as a distraction is a bad PowerPoint presentation. Whether it's a million lines of text, a disjointed flow, ugly photos or poor design, bad PowerPoint detracts you from the message you are trying to get across, while also undermining your own credibility as a professional or speaker. Now, let's see the characteristics of a great presentation. A great PowerPoint presentation is prepared to win, researched, planned, and prepared professionally so you can deliver the right message to your target audience effectively. It's designed correctly, with points that are illustrated and visually stand out without overwhelming your audience or unnecessarily complicating your message. It's practiced to perfection, rehearsed and timed so your points land as practice with your live audience. It's delivered with poise, presented with a relaxed inner calm and confident outward projection while communicated warmth, excitement and energy, free from mistakes. Devoid of cheesy clip art, nonsensical flashiness, mischievous like reading directly from promoters, and other easy to avoid problems. The first tip is know your stuff. Your presentation isn't about your slides alone, it's about the message you want to get across. Before filling in stats, facts, and figures, think about the narrative that will be discussed, why, and in what order. The next tip is write it out. Start on a Word or Google Doc and storyboard or script the entire presentation to give you an idea of how the information presented will flow and how viewers will see it in sequence. The next tip is to highlight what is the most important. A presentation covers the most crucial pieces only. Whatever you have been working on that lead to this, a paper, a work, a project, a new product design, doesn't need to be shared in its entirety. Pick key points and put the rest in an appendix to refer to during the question and answer session at the end. The next tip is to know your audience. How you talk to a room full of medical professionals should be different from the way you address a room full of young entrepreneurs. Everything, in fact, is different. Your topic selection, the language you use, the exams you give to illustrate points. The little bits of humor included should be tailored specifically with your target audience in mind. Rehearsal. It's never too early to get used to the rhythm of your presentation and take note of points you want to emphasize. While saying it loud, you will start to develop a feel for the material and notice that some things work well while others don't and might need to be worked around. Tip number 6. Rewrite after you rehearse. As you are rehearsing your presentation, you are bound to stumble over sections that don't quite flow naturally. Instead of reworking your delivery, it might be time to consider the content and rewriting the areas that serve as stumbling blocks. The most important part of creating a great presentation is the writing stage. The second most important stage is rewriting. Tip number 7. Share with a friend. If the stakes are high for your presentation, it's never too early to get feedback from those that you trust, so as to get their feedback. Tip number 8. Keep your slides simple. This is one of the most important PowerPoint presentation tips to follow when designing your slides. Keep in mind that less is more. A cluttered slide is distracting. It causes confusion for an audience. Which part of the slide should I focus on? Should I read the slide or pay attention to the presenter? But a simple, visually appealing slide will engage your audience, keeping them on track with your main points. Tip number 9. Limit words on your slides. Piggybacking on the last point, less is more effective. If possible, avoid bullets altogether. Otherwise, minimize them to just a few simple words. The audience should be listening, not reading. Tip number 10. Use high-quality photos and graphics. One of the more important tips for quality PowerPoint presentations is to use high-quality photos and graphics. People are more likely to take you seriously if your presentation is visually appealing. Users view attractive design as more usable. Similarly, they will view a more attractive PowerPoint as more effective. Tip number 11. Use accurate and relevant charts and graphs. Charts and graphs can also be distracting if they are not used right. Make sure your information design is simple and clean so that the audience doesn't spend the entire time trying to decipher what your x-axis says. Tip number 12. Use high-quality, fresh templates. Templates can be distracting if they are too basic or if the design feels dated. You need one with great design options. Tip number 13. Choose appropriate fonts. Fonts are an important part of engaging your audience. Fonts and typography choices have a subconscious effect on viewers, causing them to characterize your company's presentation and brand either positively or negatively. Make sure that you are choosing fonts that are professional and modern. Tip number 14. Choose color well. Like font choice, colors cause specific subconscious reactions from viewers. Choosing an outdated color combination for your presentation will render it ineffective. Number 15. Clean and simple formatting makes all the difference. Less is more. The focus is you and your message, not your slides. Tip number 16. Make sure all objects are aligned. A simple way to create a well-designed presentation is to make sure all items on a slide are intentionally aligned. To do this, hold down Shift key on your keyboard and select on all the objects you want to include. Then choose Arrange in the option bar and apply alignment type. The next tip is about to limit punctuation. This is not the place for exclamation points. Emphasize your points while speaking. Do not unleash punctuation to do this for you. Tip number 18. Avoid over-formatting your points. There is no need to have every word of every bullet point capitalized or to have all your bullet points in title case. If possible, drop bullets altogether. Again, the simpler the better. Tip number 19. Combine information with graphics in PowerPoint. One of the most powerful presentation skills for PowerPoint is using infographics. With the right type of visuals, slides come to life and reduce the text in favor of graphics. Informatics help combine information with graphics. It's easier to explain complex ideas when you use visual formats that are intuitive. Tip number 20. Practice with a timer. Consistency is key to an effective PowerPoint presentation. Timing should be similar, ideally the same, each time you rehearse. This one will especially pay off when it's time to present in front of your audience. Tip number 21. Slow it down. Many of the best speakers today intentionally speak slowly. You will have the chance to emphasize, appear more thoughtful, and make your information easier to digest. Tip number 22. Pause more often. Pausing more often allows main points to be emphasized and for information to sink in. You need to let key points breathe a little before rushing into the next section. Tip number 23. Choose three focal points in the room. If you stay at the same spot the entire time, your presentation will be ineffective. People will be distracted by you wondering what you are staring at. Try this. Pick three points in the room, typically left, center, and right. Take time to direct your delivery toward each physical focal point in the room. Also, focus on the center when making your primary points. Tip number 24. Vary your sentence length. This makes you sound more interesting and it's easier for your audience to follow. Think short and punchy, or go long and complex for dramatic effect. Tip number 25. Practice in front of a mirror. What you look like is as important as how you sound. Pretend as though you are having a normal conversation and allow your hands to move with your speech, emphasizing your points. Tip number 26. Don't use flashy sliding transitions. This is distracting and outdated. Use transitions and subtle animations in your PowerPoint presentation. Tip number 27. Do not read directly from your paper. Reading from your paper makes it look like you are not prepared. Many people do it, but no one should. As a general rule, you should only be presenting something you know well and have at least mostly memorized the main points of. Tip number 28. Read directly from your PowerPoint presentation. If you spend your entire presentation looking at the screen, so will your audience. They will then disengage from what you are saying and your presentation will fall flat. Tip number 29. Use the visual guides. When you are designing your next PowerPoint presentation, it helps to create a sense of visual rhythm. Slides that have objects appropriately aligned and centered are naturally more likely to resonate with an audience. Tip number 30. Add a video to your PowerPoint. When you are sharing a big idea in your presentation, it helps to share your perspective from a few different angles. Adding a video to supplement your content can do just that. Likely, it's easy to add and embed a YouTube video in your next PowerPoint presentation. Tip number 31. Add charts and graphs. Charts and graphs can help you to tell stories with data. It's easy for an audience to zone out when you throw a big data table or set of statistics at them. Instead, convert those to charts and graphs. Tip number 32. use Presenter View. Remember that when you use the PowerPoint, you are the presentation. The slides are just there to reinforce what you have got to say and support your speaking points. More often than not, you are going to have several displays. Use Presenter View to show the information that is relevant to you and on your private screen with your presentation showing on the extra display. Tip number 33. Ask questions at crucial moments. Statements should trade and expect it, especially during a presentation. Since a presentation essentially consists of a series of statements strung together, one more statement isn't likely to intrigue the audience, not even an exceptional one. A question breaks up your regular presentation rhythm and helps mark what you are saying as important. More than that, a question turns your presentation from a passive story into an active quest that the audience can explore on their own through their answers. Tip number 34. Watch your animations. Many presentation topics will include a lot of different slides, and each of those slides might hold several different types of content. Thanks to PowerPoint, it's easy to add custom animations and transitions with just a few clicks. These motions really pull off your audience in by unveiling new items with a cool flourish. Plus, they will help you bring focus to key areas and ensure viewers engage with you. But you need to be careful. Animations and slide transitions can be very distracting. Too much wild motion and you will just make your audience dizzy. Instead, opt for clean and simple movements that do not detract from your narrative. Fades and pauses are top choices for stylish and simple animations. Things like spins, stars, and wheels are options to avoid. And for the end, the tip number 35. Close strong. No matter how good your slide deck, it's absolutely key to recap and summarize at the end. After all, that's one of the best ways to ensure retention and action. Highlight key points, touching on each one and briefly recapping how it fits into the overall message. This locks your message into memory. For maximum effect, introduce a simple animation that displays the bullets one at a time. That keeps your audience focused and prevents them from skipping forward. Thank you for your attention.